Hello friends, I am Dr. Deepak Taikar. Welcome you all on my YouTube channel. Friends, today I am going to talk on particle accelerator. So the first question strikes in our mind is that what is particle accelerator? So particle accelerator is a device or an instrument which is used to accelerate or to increase kinetic energy of charged particle. मतलब particle accelerator एक device है या instrument हम जिसको बोल सकते हैं जिससे कि charged particle की energy को हम increase कर सकते हैं. Particle accelerator are classified into two category. Electrostatic accelerator and oscillating field accelerator. In case of electrostatic accelerator, static electric field, or we can say that DC electric field, is used to accelerate charged particle. On the other hand, in case of oscillating field accelerator, varying electric field, or we can say that alternating electric field, is used to accelerate charged particle. Some examples of oscillating field accelerators are linear accelerator, commonly called as LINAC, cyclic accelerator, it is also called as cyclotron, synchrocyclotron, that is the advanced version of cyclotron, betatron, etc. Now let us discuss about mechanism of a linear accelerator. So it consists of a source, here we can say that, or we can consider a positive ion source. Then there is a slit. Then there are some coaxial cylindrical metal tubes of increasing length. So you can see here tube T1, T2, T3, T4, T5 and T6, they are arranged in the order of increasing length. That means the length of cylinder T2 is greater than the length of cylinder T1. Similarly, the length of T3 is greater than the length of cylinder T2, and like that. These tubes are also called as drift tubes, because whenever particle reach between the gap of these two cylinder, the particle or that ion get accelerated, or we can say that the particle get drift in a forward direction. That's why they are called as drift tube. And all these assembly is enclosed in an evacuated glass envelope. Now, important thing you must note down here is that all even number tubes, that means T2, T4 and T6, all are connected to one terminal of RF frequency or radio frequency oscillator, and all other tubes, say T1, T3, T5, or we can say that all odd number tubes, are connected to other terminal of radio frequency oscillator. Now this radio frequency oscillator generate AC signal. So let us suppose during positive half cycle of AC signal, the tube T1, T3 and T5 are at negative potential, and even number of tubes, that means T2, T4 and T6, are at positive potential. Now suppose positive ion is generated by source. Now since T1 is at negative potential, so that positive ion get attracted towards that tube T1, Now you must note down some important thing that the ions are accelerated in the gap between two tubes and travel with constant velocity within the tube. इसका मतलब जब भी चार्ज पार्टिकल दो ट्यूब के बीच की गैप में होगा तभी पार्टिकल एक्सेलरेट होगा, उसको एनर्जी मिलेगी, और जब पार्टिकल ट्यूब के अंदर ट्रैवल करेगा सो इट ट्रैवल विथ कॉन्स्टेंट वेलोसिटी, एक कॉन्स्टेंट वेलोसिटी से वो ट्रैवल करेगा. सेकेंड थिंग यू मस्ट नोट डाउन हियर इज दैट द लेंथ ऑफ ट्यूब एंड फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ ऑसिलेटर इज एडजस्टेड इन सच ए वे दैट each time when particle reach the gap the polarity of signal get reversed. मतलब जब भी पार्टिकल दो ट्यूब के बीच की जो गैप है वहां पे जाएगा तो यहाँ पे ट्यूब की लेंथ और RF ऑसिलेटर की जो फ्रीक्वेंसी है वो इस तरह से एडजस्ट की जाती है कि जब भी पार्टिकल गैप में जाएगा तभी एसी सिग्नल की पोलैरिटी चेंज होगी या इंटरचेंज होगी. हम इसको यहाँ पे हम देख सकते हैं. सो सी हियर नाउ द नेगेटिव हाफ साइकिल स्टार्ट एंड ड्यूरिंग नेगेटिव हाफ साइकिल द पोलैरिटी ऑफ दोज ट्यूब्स गेट इंटरचेंज. नाउ ड्यूरिंग नेगेटिव हाफ साइकिल द पोलैरिटी ऑफ ट्यूब गेट इंटरचेंज. सो सी हियर द ऑड नंबर ट्यूब नाउ आर एट पॉजिटिव पोटेंशियल and even number of tube are at negative potential. So because of this the ion accelerated or attracted towards tube T2 and it travel along the axis of tube T2. That means it gain kinetic energy due to that potential. Again the ion reached a gap between T2 and T3, field reversal occur. So you can see here, now T2 becomes positively charged and T3 is at negative potential. So because of this, the ion again gain energy and accelerate towards T3 and travel along the axis of that tube. Again, same thing happen here also. In the gap between T3 and T4, the ion gain energy and accelerate towards tube T4. And the process continue as shown here. So once again, you can see this process. So look at the diagram. So you can see here every time ion reach the gap it gains energy and accelerate in forward direction. So in this way linear accelerator works. In second part I will discuss on cyclic accelerator or cyclotron. So keep watching my video and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.